Today, we're going to talk about functions, we're going to talk about linear functions. I'm not going to be excitable today, I'm just me. Linear functions are going to look like this. F of x equals ax plus b. You've seen linear functions before, but we did not write it this way. And I know what you're thinking, we didn't? How did we write them? Well, back in the day, you would have written it something like this. Y equals mx plus b. That's what you would have written back in the day. Remember how cool that guy was? Mm-hmm. What was so cool about him? Mm-hmm. What was the name for him? This was the slope-intercept form. It's the same thing as what we have here, but they're using this notation for a function so that you become familiar with this and so that it does not scare you or frighten you later. Okay. When you have something like this, you need to know that his domain is always going to be all real numbers. It's all real numbers. Now, if that lead coefficient does not equal zero, then the range will also be all real numbers from negative infinity to infinity. Okay? If you have a coefficient here of x, you know, something that's not zero, then you know it's going to be a line, it's going to be either going up or it's going to be going down, just like we've talked about before with slope. Now, if your lead coefficient, if your coefficient of x is zero, then it kind of goes back to the question that you had earlier today, Jess, about constant functions. If the lead coefficient is zero, then you basically have this guy, that f of x equals b. Doesn't matter what I plug in for x, what would I always get out? I'd always get out b, which means that my range would be just the number b. And the way that we express that is we use that set notation that you use when you're writing your solutions. Because our range contains only the number b, if you have a 0 there for the x. Not for the x, but if you have a 0 for the coefficient of x. You guys cool with that? You're not? Nobody's cool anymore? Let's give up. Let's go home.
Let's go.
Well, if you had, if that was 0, then that, never mind.
Here's what I mean by that. If I say f of x is equal to 4, remember what this means. F of x is the same thing as saying what?
Y.
So if I said y equals 4, we should know how this guy graphs because we've done this before. It means that we have a horizontal line going through 4. Okay. What's the domain in this picture? What do you see? The domain is the set of x's that are used, which is all real numbers, right? However, the range, the y values that are used in this picture, is just 4, and only 4, right? So if I had to write that out here, the domain is all real numbers.
Is there a similar sign for that other than the infinities?
Well, yeah, that...
That double line R funky thing?
Yeah, that guy. I like writing infinity. It's more fun. So that's why I write it that way.
But on the test, it'll accept the simple.
No es importante. Sí. And the range is just 4, using the little curly brackets. And you may say, Mr. Craig, I have a hard time drawing that little curly bracket here. You don't, because suppose you wanted to draw this guy right here. And you want to give him a mustache. Okay? It's the same symbol. This is what I do when I'm tired of grading your tests.
Oh, okay. You're getting bored, like, oh, he's bad.
Chris, notice this is a guy that you should be scared of. Why? He has no eyes. He just has sockets. Creepy.
divide them?
No, I just deepened the sockets.